Hello everyone, and welcome back here to Minecraft the First Few Days. Now, this is probably going to be the last episode in this series. I'm going to be showing you a few more little bits and pieces, but after that, to be honest with you, you're getting to the I'm in control of the world, let's build something pretty stage, and I think that's a bit beyond what I want to do with this series, so let's just crack on, see where we are. Now, I don't know if I've mentioned this already, but I've got all my storage organized now in my little hidey hole. So I've got coal, spruce, different types of wood, different types of stone, some meat, veg and meat, and more stone, more iron, and the all important everything else chest. Now, between episodes, I have been doing a few bits and pieces, and one of them is breeding up these cows, which, as you can see, I have quite a few of them now. So if I do want some meat or I want some leather, I just come along here with a load of wheat, feed them all up, let them have babies, kill a few, take what I need, and move on. That's getting late. Let's go and... oh, we'll talk about that building in a sec. Let's just go and rest the night, and then we'll talk some more in the morning. So, shut the door, just in case, and go to sleep. I have gone to sleep once in this sort of situation, and just as it got dark, a creeper walked in. That was so nice. Right. Okay, so, one other thing I did was I organized my tree farm, as you can see here. So I've got three of each of the three types of trees I've seen so far, and I've got them organized five squares apart, which is enough space for them to grow comfortably. And I put a torch in front of the place where I want the tree to be planted. So if I decide to cut down a tree, let's cut this one down. Like this. And, oh, there we go. Just get ourselves a sapling. Now, if you're clever, you won't be using the axe for this because it wears the axe down when the axe should be used for cutting wood. If you're going to do something like this, do it with, say, a piece of wood or something like that. Something that's not going to break and show the wear and tear, because this is not something that a tool makes easier. I'm not getting a sapling out of this, am I? Have I picked one up without realizing? No, there's a small chance that this will happen. I'd have thought, however, with a birch tree, I'd have been... had a reasonable chance of getting a sapling. Let's just do a few leaves off this one. Nothing. Good lord. Let's go and get one. So yeah, cut down a tree. I've got a lot of wood from that tree. Seven pieces of wood. That's 28 planks. And so I go to my birch wood. I'll pop that in there because I don't need it just a second. Pick up a sapling because I didn't get one from that tree, which is quite scary. And we'll just go back and just pop that there, replant it. Now, okay, one last thing. I don't know if you've noticed, but there's a block of wood floating in the air above each one of these oak trees. And the reason for that is I want to restrict the height that these grow to, because oak trees have two forms. They're like this, four or five sticks with a load of leaves around it. But sometimes they grow like this, which is lots and lots of sticks and then loads of pieces of wood all over the place and loads of leaves. And quite frankly, these things can be a pain to cut down. And in the end, what you normally do is just cut as much wood as you can easily and set fire to the rest. And I don't really want to do that in this sort of situation because it'd be far too easy for me to set fire to everything. However, because these can't grow above... eight blocks, they're very unlikely to become that complex, so it just makes things easier. Okay, so in the last episode we were looking at crops and we were starting a sample farm over there, and we ran into the problem where it wasn't irrigating properly because the water was freezing. So between episodes I've given some thought and I've come up with a few different ways of dealing with the fact. Now, there's two real ways of stopping the water from freezing, and this is the first one. So this farm here does extend down into the ground here where it's a cold biome, but it starts off up the top here where it's warm. Okay, this is an extreme hills biome, which is warmer than the icy plains down there. So this block of water here will never freeze. And as it runs down here, down towards the cold biome, because this water is moving, it will never freeze as well. So this is a perfectly adequate farm. It does have the slight problem that it's actually quite easy to accidentally drop onto the ploughed land, which destroys it, so you have to take great care, but other than that, it works perfectly fine. So that's one way of dealing with the problem. Another one is over here. So I had a bit of sand, so I built myself a greenhouse. And that is what this is. So we have a spruce wood frame here with lots and lots of glass. Now this counts as indoors. But the light levels, because of the glass, are exactly the same here as they would be if it was outside. And that means, you know, these plants will grow during the day just as well as that farm over there. Now, if you don't want to use lots and lots of glass, or you want to build your farm underground or something like that, you can do that. Just put lots and lots of torches. And those torches will do the job of illuminating the plants. The plants will grow, and there's no problems with that. The final way of doing it is that. I've just put a half slab over the top of the water area. Now you can still see the water underneath the half slab because these ploughed blocks have a little bit of space at the top, but it still counts as covered, so that water never freezes. This irrigates quite nicely, and the job is done. So there you go. We now have three different ways of making a farm in these adverse conditions, and there's plenty more, not least of which the one we were talking about earlier on, which is building a whole thing underground. So yeah, so we have plenty of wheat, plenty of cow. I found a couple of chickens while I was away. I did some caving over there between episodes while waiting for things to grow, and I found a couple of chickens, brought them back here, put them in here, getting plenty of eggs from them. Let's see if we get another chicken out. Here we go. Another two chickens. Our chicken population has increased by 50%. And finally, while looking around, I found a sheep. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to go and get that sheep and see if we can bring it back. It was over here. Let's run over there. Plenty of food now, so don't particularly worry about starving, so I can do things like run, which is nice. There we go. Is there a second one? If there is, I can't see it, or it's pretending to be a spider. Do love the visual effects you're getting here. They're marvellous. It does make it really hard to see what is... Hello. This is very hard to see what is ice and what is water. But I think this is ice going across here, so let's get you... Here we go. Let's get you back. I've got a nice new home for you. And we're going to find you a friend to live with. And we're going to harvest your wool and give you plenty of wheat. And eventually we shall take some of your offspring and dye them. And we'll make lots of color-coordinated pens. Well, possibly not. I think that's a bit beyond the series, to be honest with you. So let's get this guy back here. And this is only going to take a minute, but what the hell? Let's speed it up. Squeaky voice time. Something about sheep. They just have this urge to breakdance. I've no idea why, but they just seem to enjoy it. Come here. Come here. Look. Look. Wheat. Yes, I know you need to give in to your inner Michael Jackson, but thank you. So there we go. Our first sheep. So let's get rid of that. And We will come back for your wall later on. Okay, other things. Let's eat some bread. There's two other things I'd really like to do with you guys before I call this quits. Well, actually three, I think. There's a third little thing. Two of them are going to be a bit montagey, but as we're getting towards the end of the day, let's go and start doing one of them. And it's just a simple way of building a comfortable place to fight mobs. And we're going to do it up here. And effectively, what we're going to do is just we're going to answer a few questions. Okay, now I want a place where I can fight mobs, and I want to do it in such a way that I'm going to be less likely hurt by them. So what we need to do is think about each mob in turn. And the first one we'll think about is zombies. I know we want zombies not to hurt us. So what we do with zombies is, if we build a fence, in fact, let's put a gate there. If we build a fence, then six, then the zombies can't get into the cat fighters. So we're going to put a fence up here, which is the first step. We're now quite comfortable. We can stand here with our sword, fight zombies. The zombies are going to be very unlikely to hit us. So we dealt with zombies. Now what about skeletons? Skeletons can stand no way over there and shoot arrows at us. So the way we're dealing with skeletons is to block their line of sight, which we can do quite easily like this. So if I see a skeleton over there, run down here. Skeleton can't see me now, so it has to get closer. As soon as it gets close, I can jump up and hit it with my sword. So that skeleton sorted out. Let's think about the next one, which is spiders. Now spiders are a bit of a problem because we've got this fence here, but they can climb over it. We can deal with that problem by not allowing them to climb over it. Fences are 1.5 blocks high, but just look 1 block high. So if we actually take some dirt, oops, and just put it there. Let's just get our way back down here. Like that. Okay, so that looks like there's a block space between there, but there isn't. There is only half a block space. So if we just carry on and put this barrier all the way around here, no spider is going to be able to climb over that fence. So that is another mob that we have basically weakened. So we can now stand here in the center, comfortable in the idea that we can just swing our swords at spiders and they're not going to be able to hit us, or not as likely to. So, next mob. Let's do Endermen. Endermen can teleport in here. We don't want them to teleport in here. But Endermen are 3 blocks tall. So if we fill this in... Oh, we have our first customer. Hello. Hello. There we go. Our first customer, our first kill. So, let's carry on filling this in. Get rid of that, because I put that in the wrong place. So, there we go. Endermen could possibly teleport in that pit there, but let's face it, if they do that, they're going to regret it. Right, so we've done zombies, we've done spiders, we've done skeletons, we've done endermen, creepers. Creepers are still a bit of a problem. If you're standing here and a creeper is standing on the other side of there, it'll explode. So if you see a creeper, stand back from the fence. Don't necessarily have to fall down the hole to do it. But if you stand a distance away, you're going to get hit in. And if they look like they're going to explode, just duck down here. And occasionally, if you can, just pop up and shoot them with arrows. So that just leaves witches. And witches are still a problem. but they're a problem easily fixed with a bow. So I'm going to spend the night here, and what I will do is I will just do a quick montage of everything I fight overnight. Actually, I'm thinking about it. Let's light this place up a little bit as well. So, see you in a bit. Okay, well, that was a reasonable haul for one night. Two spider's eye, 13 pieces of string, 19 rotten flesh, a potato. If I didn't have an up to now, that would be a whole new food for me. 3 gunpowder, 3 bones, that's 9 bone meal. That's a lot of ability to grow. 11 arrows and 2 bows, which I can repair into my bow quite easily. So, as you can see, that was a fairly hectic night, but it paid off well. And as an extra bonus, as the sun was coming up, I ran into this guy who decided to follow me home. So we now have a pair. Let's go for 3, shall we? Doink. And doink. And go on, do the sheepy kiss. Go on. Don't be embarrassed. We're not looking, really, honestly. No idea what the problem is with these guys. Come on. Just consider me the sheep love doctor. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Go on, you can do it. There we go. Hey, no idea what happened there, but we got there in the end, and we now have 3 sheep. Okay. Oh, almost had 2 sheep again. Right, I want some wool off those sheep, so let's go and make ourselves a pair of shears. I don't think we have any at the moment. I'd be very surprised if we do. No, we don't, but before we do go anywhere, let's just put this stuff away. I think that shovel can go with my other worn out shovel, so we'll make another one. And there we go. We'll keep the arrows. That was a very good haul that night. So we'll put that potato with the veggies. Get ourselves the iron I got the other day. And we'll make ourselves a pair of shears, which is like that. So we'll take them. Oh, I forgot to put the spider's eyes away. Spider eyes are very useful in potion making, which you can't do until you go to the Nether, so it's probably a bit beyond this series, but if you get them, keep them. Okay. Sheep and wool. You can shear sheep, you make a pair of shears, you right-click on the sheep, and you get some wool. You can't shear babies, but you get 1 to 3 sheep wool per sheep, so I must have got 1 off of one and 2 off another there, but that is perfectly fine. And what will happen now is every few minutes these sheep will eat. When they eat, We get a patch of bare earth here, like you can see there, and their wool grows back. So you can come from time to time, just shear the sheep, get their wool back. Okay, so now I have three wool, I can make a bed. I don't need to make a bed here, but I still have a spawn house. And all told, it would be nice if I could put a bed there, just in case. So I'm going to do that now. Make us a bed, and then take a run over to the spawn house, which I'm going to do right now, and probably in compressed speed. And here we are. Remember this, guys? This is where we got our first cobblestone. In fact, we got our second lot of cobblestone as well. Some pigs, but to be honest, we don't need pigs anymore. It would be nice to have a complete set, you know, pigs and rabbits and perhaps some horses, but that'll come later on. But right here we are, back where we started off. Here's our little spawn house. And let's put a bed there. Just check our stuff. Yeah, we left a set of weapons and armor there for if we ever find ourselves back at spawn. Well, we now have a bed to pass the night as well, which is going to be really quite useful. Oh, look, nesting pig. Right. Back to home. Right, we got ourselves back to base just in time for it to start snowing. Isn't it nice? Right, okay, there is one more thing I want to do, and once we've got that sorted, look, this grass is starting to snow over again. Once we've got this sorted, we are more or less in a situation where we are comfortable and we can go on to more advanced stuff. And what we need to do now is build. Ooh, hello. I thought it was daytime enough for you not to be aggro. Obviously, I was wrong. Yeah, we need to build ourselves a mine. And I think I'm going to do that right over here. Let's get rid of that creeper first. Hello, Mr. Creeper. Bye-bye, Mr. Creeper. Okay. Yeah, we're going to build it here. And like all things that I do, let's do a bit of design around this. So let's make ourselves a place for our let's have some I'll tell you what, let's have some oak wood. We'll have some oak wood. We will chop down a spruce tree because I want the spruce doors, and we're going to want a bit of glass, I think. So we'll have that. And that, and let's just make ourselves just a little hut. We'll do it here. Oh, I have some oak wood, that'll do. So let's build, yeah, it's about here, I think. So there we go, mine entrance. Safety hats to be worn at all times. And seeing as my hat, in fact, to be honest, all my armor is broken, let's just go and make myself a new set quickly. I think actually, while I'm at it, let's make ourselves an extra chest. And I'm going to pop that down here. And I'm just going to put my old stuff in there, because at the start of the game, certainly, these mostly worn out items have a use, and the use is you can combine them with other mostly worn out items. Let's just grab my mostly worn out items from here. Oh, run out of space. Let's put these swords up here. And a bow. Yep, there's the other bow. Okay, and you see, if you got a worn out, say, a worn out pick, and you have a... Where on earth did I... there it is. Okay, let's try that again. If you have a worn out pick, like this one, and another worn out pick like this one, that haven't been destroyed, you can put them together. And you can see this one's got a durability of 4, and this one's got a durability of 30. Together, combined, they got a durability of 46. So they actually can combine to more than the parts. And if you just keep on combining your worn out picks, fairly soon you will just get another fresh pick without having to expend any resources on it, which at the start of the game is really, really useful. So let's just pop that up there. Got that. I need a new sword. I might as well get myself a new sword while I'm at it. Need some iron. 1, 2. And let's make that quickly. So that stick. And that iron. Nice fresh new sword. And let's put away the stuff that I got while digging. So plenty of gravel, plenty of cobble. There's more gravel. And cobblestone we shall store because it's useful for building. If you keep a chest of it, you never know. You might not ever use it for actual design, but quite frankly, it's just useful to have the stuff. There we go. Right, so that's granite. That's dirt. We'll put somewhere else. Andesite. Diorite. Dirt goes in here. Okay. I think actually I want to keep a bit of that on me, so I always got some stuff to put down. And that iron, I'm going to get smelted. And finally, let's make ourselves a new kit because I'm sorely lacking. So, safety helmet, safety trousers, safety vest, and safety boots. There we go. Put the last of that iron away and put on my new stuff. There I am in a fresh new set of tin. Hey! Right. And here is the entrance to my mine. Just put a wall around it. Just makes a lot of sense because then nothing's going to follow you around provided you remember to close the door. This is really rough and ready as these go. There's actually a cave around here which I just went through and bricked up behind me because I just wanted to get down here and make the base, the mining base, which is all the way down here at level 10. Now I'm not going to take stuff out of the walls, but I think I will take this. We'll do as we usually do with diamond. We'll dig around it just to make sure that there is no lava or something like that it's going to fall into. And it's just worth the extra effort. Okay, like that. I think that's all we got this time. Yeah. Okay, so we dug all the way around that. We know this is all we're going to get. We don't have a fortune pickaxe, so let's just go and mine it out. So before we even got to the bottom of the mine, we've got ourselves 4 lovely diamonds. Actually, let's get this redstone while we're at it. And let's fill this hole in temporarily. Now, if you're going to spend just a lot of time in an area, as you certainly will in a mine, it's entirely worth coming back and just doing some design just to make the area look prettier, which is certainly what I would do here if in my world. But right now what I want to do is just get us in a state where we can just do a bit of mining, and we're going to call it quits there. Now we are down, we've dug all the way down to level 10, as you can see on the XYZ there. That's the reason, because this is pretty much the lowest level you're going to dig down and have a high chance of finding diamonds. Below this you will find diamonds, but you also find a lot of bedrock which can't be mined through, which makes mining very hard. But there's actually less diamonds below this point than there is for 4 or 5 levels above this point. So we're going to start digging here, but I've also created another level here. So later on I will create another mining platform here and dig out as well. But for now, got myself just a little area organized, well lit up. I've got a crafting bench, a furnace, and just somewhere to store stuff. I don't want to carry that with me. So let's just stick all this in a chest. Stuff we don't need. We just leave it there and move on. And the way I mine is pick a point just below the divide between the top and the bottom block, and just walk forward, looking forwards, because you will dig above and below, just like that. Looks like we've come through to a place I've already explored. Oh, I remember this. Okay, so if you come through to a cave, or you come through to lava, just explore it quickly, light up, and carry on. I don't need lava at this point, so I'm not going to collect any. If you find pools of lava, use your bucket of water, or use some blocks just to brick it up, and carry on. So dig a little bit further here, and then we'll venture down, so we're back on level 10, and just carry on this way, and just carry on until you get bored. As you find resources, dig them out the walls. Another area I've been to, exploring, so we'll just carry on through. And as you find resources, just dig them out the wall and move on. Like this. So we'll dig this coal out. Like this. Nice big block of coal here, which we wouldn't have found while caving. So that's a nice find. There we go. We'll chuck some light in there. Always keep these lit. Less chance of mobs surprising you while you're mining. So mine that out. Move on. Okay, so that is branch mining. You just pick a direction, dig in it. Once you've dug as far as you want to in that direction, move over a couple, dig some more. So we dig here. And so on. And we can do exactly the same over this side. Okay, so we dig a tunnel here, and we'd dig a tunnel here. Once we've dug in those directions, then the obvious thing to do is pick a direction and dig a tunnel this way. So we would dig one here. Once we'd dug in that direction, we'd move, put two blocks between us and dig one there, put two blocks between us, dig one there, and so on. Okay. Reason for the two blocks is if you've dug here, you've seen these two blocks. And if you're digging here, you'll see those two blocks. So you don't actually need to dig them, because you know what's there already. So that's fine. So it's just maximizing the coverage. There are other mining strategies. Some are more or less efficient. I just like using this one. experiment, pick one you like. So this is my mining setup now, okay? So I can quite quickly find a shaft, dig it out, extract the resources, and move on. Okay, so we are now in a situation where we have our mining setup, we have a farming setup, we have livestock, we've got obsidian here, we've got diamonds to make an obsidian pickup, so we make this, we can make an enchanting table, and in fact, let's make that our last thing. There's my diamonds, So let's make ourselves quickly a diamond pickaxe. Okay, like that. And we shall use the diamond pickaxe because it's the only thing that will to mine this obsidian. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm just making a little hole to the side of the obsidian. Because what I want to do is... Actually, I will put it like that. What I want to do is make sure that the obsidian I don't mine doesn't fall into any lava that might be below. So after doing that, I take my bucket of water, put the water in there. Now if I mine out this piece of obsidian, which takes a while with an unenchanted pickaxe. There you go. The water rushes in. If there was lava underneath, the water would turn the lava to cobblestone before the obsidian fell into it, so it's perfectly safe. So let's get... I want 5 pieces of obsidian. So let's just grab those now. Alright, we got that. Let's pick up a water and move on. So let's go back up to the surface and make ourselves an enchanting bench. I'll see you up there. Okay, we're up here. I've rested the night. Let's get the stuff that is needed to make a enchanting table. So we're going to need 2 diamonds. That leaves us with 3, which is great. And we're going to need 5 obsidian, which we've got. And we are going to need a book. And a book is paper. Do we have any paper? Nope, haven't made any paper. But I've got some sugar somewhere. I think I left it down in the mine. So let's go and get some sugar. We're going to need 3 pieces of sugar. Ooh. Hello, you. Woohoo! Let's fill in our hole. Exactly the right number. Yay! Right. So let's grab some of this sugar cane. Like that. Yeah, they're sure they're all still planted. They actually are. And we're going to need some leather, so let's go and happen to some cows. Right. Oops. Gave us some meat. Actually, let's make a space in a bar so we'll know. We just need 1 leather. And there we go. That's all we need. Right, let's go and make ourselves an enchanting table. Okay, so. First of all, we need to make the book. We do that by making 3 sheets of paper and we lay them out. It's just this is a shapeless crafting recipe, so you can just put them in any order, just like that. Then we have the book at the top, obsidian like that, and diamonds either side. And that gives us an enchantment table. And an achievement. And quite frankly, the funkiest bedside table known to man. Alright. In order to enchant, we need some lapis. It's because this is 1.8. So let's see what we can put on our diamond pickaxe. We can get efficiency. Something wrong here. Oh, of course, lacking bookcases. Right, so let's just explain that quickly, actually. Right. An enchanting table on its own will give you a certain level of enchantment. If you surround it with bookcases, it increases the enchantment. Now, we don't actually have space for bookcases here. And quite frankly, I don't really have the materials at this point. But to make a proper enchanting room, I think you're going to want about 15 bookcases within two blocks of the enchantment table. But as it is, we don't have it. On the other hand, however, we can do this enchantment, which is efficiency. And efficiency makes whatever your enchanting work better. And that seems like a good improvement. So that axe is slightly better. So we can make axes. We can, in fact, let's do that because we still have plenty of levels. We can make books and we can enchant the books like this. Okay, so this is offering us a range of enchantments, so you can make this book a Bane of Arthropods, a Sharpness one, an Efficiency one. So let's just do that. Okay, we now have a Sharpness one book, and I can use that anvil to combine that sharpness with, say, an axe or a sword to make a Sharpness one sword. On the other hand, I can just do that and see what I get. And I can get my sword Unbreaking, or I can make it Bane of Arthropods. Bane of Arthropods is makes it more effective against spiders. Unbreaking makes it last longer. So let's make an Unbreaking sword here. So I've got an Unbreaking 1 sword, an Efficiency 1 pickaxe. And I can carry on enchanting things until I run out of levels, basically. So let's put this bow in here. Okay. I can make a power one bow, a power one bow, or a power one bow, depending on which, how much lapis lazuli, or and also how many enchantment levels. Okay, doing this enchantment cost me one lapis and one level, two lapis, two levels, three lapis, three levels. Now, they all say power one, but this could be power one and a load of other stuff. Or this could be power one and a load of other stuff. To be totally honest with you, bows here are always power one. So do I do safe or do I gamble? I've got lots of levels, let's gamble. I just got a power one, so I lost there. But never mind. So there you go. This is how you enchant things. The final thing you want here is an anvil. I'm wondering, do I have it? Yeah, I have more than enough iron to make an anvil. Let's make an anvil quickly. So, for making an anvil, you need three iron blocks. Like that. And four more pieces of iron like this. Alright, like that. Let's place the iron anvil down, which is an even stranger bedside table. So if I wanted to, say, take my Unbreaking 1 sword and add a Sharpness 1 book to it, I can pay one level to make an Unbreaking 1 Sharpness 1 sword. Okay, and I can also rename things. So pointy bit forward, which is... it cost me another level to do. So now I have the mighty sword, pointy bit forward, as you can see there, which is Unbreaking 1 and Sharpness 1. So it does a bit more damage and it will last a little longer. And that's the basics of enchantment. And I've got to be honest with you guys, by this point, You're in control of your environment. What should we do here from now on? Let's light up this area. Let's make mine, get lots and lots of coal. Make lots and lots of torches. Put them down around here. That way, things are far less likely to spawn around your house, and you're less likely to run into things like the creeper there. Improve your environment. Let's make a better house. So I think we're hitting the limits of this one now. The shaft down to the mine here is horrible. Let's make it look pretty. We now have access to obsidian. If you make it, if you use an obsidian gateway, you can make a portal through to the Nether. That gives you access to quartz. Quartz is needed for redstone construction. I made a really, really basic mob farm over there. There's far more advanced mob farms that can be made that will just get you items, or get you experience, or get you both. Yeah, this is the point where the world becomes your oyster. And I think this is the point where I think this this tutorial is done about as far as it needs to be. If you want to ask questions, ask questions. If I can answer them, I will happily answer them. But what I'm going to say now is go forth, play, have fun, make mistakes, learn from them. It's the best way. And I'm just going to say it with a final view of the house, the greenhouse over there, all our cows and our new sheep. I'm going to say I've been Simon Parsons. This has been Minecraft the first few days. Thank you and good night.